Here at home, several local government units suspend classes due to rains brought by the southwest monsoon. Classes are suspended in all levels in public and private schools in Valenzuela City starting at noon today, September 20. Work in government offices as well as COVID vaccination activities are also suspended. The cities of Caloocan, Navotas, and Marikina also canceled classes in all levels. Outside Metro Manila, the province of Rizal called off classes in all levels in both public and private schools. Now that the Philippine government has addressed work-from-home arrangements, a labor group wants authorities to tackle other labor issues confronting workers. Joyce Balancho with the details.
27-year-old Jay Morales has been working as an IT consultant under a hybrid work setup for more than 3 years. He goes to his office for 2 to 3 days, and on some days, he works from home. Jay admits this incurs more expenses for his family, but he still prefers this work arrangement than working on-site full-time.
Yes, beneficial siya. I am readily available to my family as soon as they need me in terms of emergencies. Some of the household chores, I need to have a routine, not just for myself, but for my wife and for my kid as well. Once I enter this room, my office area, they know that I'd be starting to work. And as soon as I get out of it, it's time for family.
Under the new order of the Department of Labor and Employment, Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma said that employers can still implement remote work programs such as work from home and other alternative work arrangements amid the continuous threat of the COVID-19 virus. The order also expanded the definition of the alternative workplace as any location where work through the use of telecommunication is performed. These may include but not limited to the employee's residence, co-working spaces, and other areas where mobile working is allowed. Employers are in favor of the new order as long as it will be voluntary.
Basta huwag lang compulsory. So kahit patagalin mo nila yan, okay lang yan. It just protect the rights of those who are already working. We're just encouraged, hindi pinipilit. So okay lang yun. Mm-hmm. Okay lang yun. Basta at the end of the day, it's the choice of the company whether they would like it or not.
Labor group Kilosang Mayo Uno also agrees with the intent of the DOLI order but insists that government should also address other issues confronting workers.
While we appreciate itong immediate moves ng Department of Labor, yung kailangan talaga bigyan ng kagyat na pagtugon ng gobyerno, no, through its lead agency nga, ay yung demand namin for a national minimum wage, yung wage increase, pagbabasura sa eskemang kontraktualisasyon, yung ito na, na yung occupational safety and health, at yung tumitinding trade union and human rights violation.
The Trade Union Congress of the Philippines, or TUCP, said there should be a mechanism for workers to raise complaints if they face abuse or unfair labor practices during these alternative work arrangements.
What is critical is that workers know that they have the right. Second, that this is a precautionary language that's needed in the department order to prevent corporate impunity, yung pag-aabuso ng mga employers sa kanilang mga work-from-home workers. Ano? They could be subjected to unreasonable quotas, unreasonable demands for that are based on quotas or on extension of their work hours beyond 8 hours. Marami hong consequences if workers cannot raise complaints.
TUCP also encourages the government to give incentives to companies that provide allowances for internet and electricity expenses and other support to workers. The IT and Business Process Association of the Philippines believes that work from home and hybrid setups will be a contributing factor for them to create 1.1 million additional jobs for Filipinos, as well as generate more revenues in the industry. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.